Welcome to an Island54 quick tip for Unity 3D. You'll often hear that singleton pattern should be avoided because it increases coupling between components and makes it harder to test your code. Well, sometimes when you're trying to move fast, dependency injection via Unity's object hierarchy can feel clunky and introduce its own problems. I often end up using singleton pattern anyway, and here's how I implement it. I have an abstract class that uses the curiously recurring template pattern, so declaring a singleton incorrectly will likely generate a compiler error. Anytime someone accesses the instance property, I check if it's already been defined. If not, I construct it. It's a constructor that sets the instance field, because the Unity editor will sometimes call the constructor directly. I give it a nice name so that I can see it in the hierarchy while the game is running, but ask that it not be saved in case singletons get unexpectedly referenced in edit mode. Using it is as simple as inheriting from this base class in the class I want to be a singleton, and I can now access the singleton instance from anywhere in my code. Eagle-eyed viewers will notice that this is not thread safe, but that's intentional. We can't create game objects from anything but the main thread anyway, and there is a workaround. Just create an object in your game hierarchy and it'll be constructed before the Unity lifecycle begins. Other threads can now access the singleton to their heart's content. One last thing, you might be tempted to throw an exception if the constructor gets called multiple times. It's best to just log a warning or error though, since the Unity editor will sometimes call the constructor directly, causing all kinds of issues while you're developing your game. Be sure to subscribe for more tips like this one and to follow along as I develop my survival crafting MMO.